Eric Stewart, thank you for accepting this interview. You are coming here. You had a lot of meetings. You met President Băsescu, Prime Minister Ponta, and I understand that you also met some other ministries. Which are the most important issues that you raised during these meetings?
The most important issues are really the general business climate type issues. Every company, no matter where they're doing business and looking to do business anywhere in the world, are always looking for the same business climate. They're looking for stability, they're looking for predictability and transparency. And one other, I think, facet that we're always looking for is engagement. If the government isn't talking to the companies, it doesn't treat the companies like a partner in the process, it's likely going to fail. It's not going to work because there's always going to be issues, no matter what relationship, whether it's a marriage between a man and a woman or whether it's a bilateral relationship between countries, there's always going to be issues. But the measurement of the strength of the relationship is how you address those issues. So we spend a lot of time talking about general business climate issues, but also specific company issues that were being raised with the government to let them know that there are some issues and to ask for help in resolving those.
Did you find that the Romanian officials, the Romanian authorities that you met, are engaging themselves into this dialogue for real, or the signals are rather mixed?
The best measurement is how the issues get resolved, right? And you know, we don't expect any government to fix everything we would like. That, you know, that doesn't always happen. That doesn't happen in America. That doesn't happen anywhere. But the willingness to work on those issues is really the measurement. And so we'll see. But I can tell you that the meetings that we had with the Prime Minister and with the President and with the various ministers, there's a real strong desire to attract more investment and to ensure that the current businesses here are satisfied. And that's, you know, that's a very important signal from the government, that there's a real willingness to make sure that this relationship stays healthy. America and Romania have a long-standing special relationship, and mostly in political, strategic, military. I think our mutual objective is that at this point is to really strengthen the commercial and economic.
Which are the ministers that you met during this visit?
A lot of them. We met in a as we say, in a plenary session with the foreign minister and with a minister of economy. But then we have 10 companies on our delegation. Those 10 companies then went off to individual meetings with some of the more ministries on specific issues like environment, like transportation, like healthcare. And they had more just individual conversations.
On a scale from 1 to 10, how business friendly is Romania right now?
That's a tough question. It depends on if you're measuring it against the Central Europe or you're measuring it against the world. I would generally say that Romania is very interested in having more American business, very interested in making sure that the companies are satisfied. I think probably the most important thing that we could really do at this point in our relationship is to develop a strategy, to develop a roadmap, to develop a working mechanism that we can talk about these issues. But you know, the feeling that I have, again, from these 2 days of meetings, is that there's a real desire for engagement. We also experienced this during Prime Minister Ponta's visit to Washington, a real desire to engage. And that's, I think, unique to Romania, because you don't always have that in every country.
How can we explain then the fact that the Prime Minister engaged, and all the Romanian authorities, that the ministers that you met in United States 2 weeks ago, they engage themselves into setting up a friendly business environment, without many changes in the fiscal policy. And 2 weeks after, the Romanian and foreign companies operating in Romania found that the government is preparing new taxes without discussing them with the business environment. How can you explain this?
Yeah, budgets are tough. I will say that, very, very tough. And U.S. is a great example of how tough budgets are, and we've had an inability to balance our budget. Taxes are unfortunately a necessary part of running any government. We from the business community, of course, are always in favor of less and lower taxes, but we understand the and recognize the need for them. I would continue to encourage, obviously, the government to talk with the companies so they understand what the taxes are for, why, how long they're going to be in place, are there sunset provisions, as we say, or are they going to phase out? Because from a corporate perspective, you can prepare a business plan and a strategy for 5 years if you know what the taxes will be. If they're going to be unpredictable, then that creates an environment that is not friendly to business. And so, you know, it's important. We did discuss it during our meetings. We raised those issues with the government officials. And hopefully there's a real willingness to make sure that the environment is predictable and transparent.
We had in the last week some strong positions from the business community, from MCHEM, from the Foreign Investors Council and some local business associations who are speaking loudly against, and this for the first time when they are speaking the same language, against the government's moves, which were, of course, unpredictable. Did you feel during your visit here that those companies, maybe you met or some of them are represented in your association, a nervousness among the business community?
There's always going to be uncertainty. If there weren't things to complain about, then there wouldn't be opportunities for business associations and groups. There wouldn't be as much of a role. It'd be more of just a networking organization. So it's important. It's an important part of the process. This is the same reason that we have large chambers of commerce and chambers of business in the U.S. as well, to complain about what our government is implementing and doing. But I think, again, from our perspective, the key word is engagement, and the key is to making sure that there's an open conversation and an open dialogue on these types of issues. And you know, we consider the AmCham and some of these business groups to be, you know, allies of ours as well, because from the corporate perspective, we all are fairly aligned and have similar feelings in the sense that you want less government, and you want less taxes, you want obviously the predictability and the transparency. But my sense is, and again, I think this is unique to Romania, my sense is that there's a real opportunity for very high-level discussions between the business community and the government of Romania at the very highest level with the president and the prime minister. And again, that's not always something that happens in every country. So I'm appreciative of the Romanians' willingness to have a listen.
Do you feel right now that Romania is among the countries in the region the most proactive country when we talk about doing businesses with American companies?
Yeah, I think so. And I think a lot of it has to do with our special relationship. There's a real... And there's a real desire, I mean, of Romanians who have immigrated to the U.S. We have a very long-standing special relationship, and there's a very large, obviously, diaspora. But I think really from a corporate standpoint, when you evaluate Central Europe and you look at the region, you look at the new members of the European Union, Poland certainly is on the top of the list because of its size, but Romania is right there as well. I've actually seen in my time in Washington and doing business that a lot of the companies are looking at both countries. And looking at both countries to do more investment and more business. And you know, we have seen the Romanians being very proactive and wanting to attract more American company, more American business, and asking the right question, which is, what can we do to bring you here?
How much matters in this mutual interest the fact that Romania, that the United States had chosen Romania for the anti-missile shield? How much?
For the defense companies, there's certainly interest, obviously, because there are opportunities to for business and for the defense industry. But politics really don't play a role. You know, diplomacy doesn't really play a role in American company decisions. It's helpful when we have a very positive and strong relationship, but it's not the role of the government to go to, you know, companies and say, you know, Romania is our greatest friend, so, you know, please go do business there. America doesn't do business that way.
A CEO from an American company think something like this? I want to invest somewhere abroad in Europe. I have to choose a country. Maybe Romania is more interesting than any other countries, because the my government trusted this country enough to invest a lot in it by putting that anti-missile shield. So I can trust to this country.
It's not impossible. My experience has been most investment decisions and most business decisions are simply made on facts and opportunities. I mean, for example, the agriculture industry in Romania, there's a tremendous amount of potential in agriculture and tremendous amount of potential in energy. That's what the companies are looking for. But, you know, at the end of the day, my real sense is that a lot of these are built on relationships and people having relationships with Romanians. And that's why during my time here, I encouraged all the ministers and the president and the prime minister that I met with to please come to the U.S. Because as the corporate executives develop a relationship with the ministers and with the government, then there's a personal connection and then there's an interest to learn more, to find out more. If the prime minister makes a great impression, as he did during his visit in Washington, then American executives, well, hey, let's find out more about Romania. Let's look into it more. Let's see what other opportunities exist.
Yes. Let's go back to your meetings here in Romania. Which are the things that Romania should or could improve in order to make the country more interesting for American businesses? The level of taxes, the bureaucracy, the predictability, political and economical, the labor force, meaning the education. Which are the things that should be improved?
It really comes down to the transparency and the predictability. The bureaucracy of any government is really a huge impediment. And that's something that, you know, is a huge, it's an impediment in America, it's an impediment in Romania. So the greater the government's ability to streamline and to knock out the red tape and to make it simpler and to put things like innovative technologies into making the process easier and simpler and more transparent, it will go a long, long way. The labor force in Romania is phenomenal. It really is tremendous. The workers here have a very positive, can-do attitude. They're very intelligent. They are very focused on IT. They're entrepreneurial. I mean, what I hear from the companies is the labor force is tremendous. The one concern that I have heard is not having enough of the labor force that have the right technical skills or have learned. And so I think that's why areas like bringing in vocational schools and working on those types of things will be very important. But really at this point, it's about the transparency, because things like taxes, again, if a company understands what the taxes are gonna be and they understand, they can calculate that into the equation. What they can't calculate is bureaucracy and slowness of process and red tape and bureaucracy that stops projects from happening. That's what they cannot calculate, and that's what makes it a high risk.
So this is one of the main.
It's one of the main. Yeah.
That you are discussing.
Absolutely, about. The efficiency of the government has to be very strong.
And did you receive a positive feedback from the Romanian authorities regarding this very point?
Yeah, it's something they understand. It's something that's been it's been discussed. When the Prime Minister was in Washington, he of course met the Vice President of our country. They talked about this. He met our Commerce Secretary. They discussed this issue. So it's something that they're very aware of, and most governments are aware of. But fixing it is much harder than talking about it. And we understand that. And the commitment that we have made in our discussions, and we actually had, we were asked to participate, the business community were asked to participate in the strategic partnership conversations which take place between the American and Romanian governments. They asked us to come in and to provide our feedback and input into the process, which again is a very, very positive step. But I think what needs to happen now is some action plans, some strategy, some roadmap that will help us and Romania get to that objective of how do we make this a more transparent business environment. And what that allows me to do, based in Washington, based in America, is to better promote Romania. If there's a plan, if there's a strategy, if you can demonstrate that the government is taking this very seriously and has a plan to address it and plan to fix it, it's a great selling point to attract further investment and further companies to do business.
So you took part yesterday in a meeting at the Foreign Affairs Ministry at a reunion of the task force group set up between Romania and the United States. Can we expect this? One of these roadmaps that you are talking about for the economy to emerge from this task force meetings?
We're certainly hopeful. We had some discussions about that, and I think that's the hope, is that we can come together, not just my council, but we can come together as the U.S. government, the Romanian government, our organization, AmCham, various business groups. We can come together and put together some type of strategy like that. I think that would go a very long way in really further enhancing our bilateral relationship.
Coming back to investments and businesses, we know that there are already a lot of American companies, big or medium companies, investing in Romania, investing significantly. In which fields can we expect new investments from now on?
I think the fields of greatest promise for Romanian future investment is agriculture. There's a lot to be done in agriculture, and there's a lot of interest from American companies in doing more business with Romania.
Can we expect new companies coming into this sector, or the companies that are already here expanding that business?
It's both. Yeah, it's really both, and that's an important message that we delivered as we were here. The media always wants to hear about the new big investment that creates 1,000 jobs. What we continue to reiterate is the creation of jobs that doesn't get announced. When a current investor hires 5 more people, or 6 more people, or 3 more people, or they open a new office in a small rural area and it only has 5 people, that doesn't make the news. But those are the types of investments that are absolutely critical, which is why having these types of missions and these types of dialogues are important. But I think agriculture is key. Energy certainly is key. And I would say energy in an all of the above type strategy. Conventional, unconventional, renewable. There's a lot of opportunities. Wind. There's a lot of opportunities for doing business, and I think also in the innovative sectors as well. I think there's a lot of opportunities for American companies. Many of the very large American IT companies are heavily invested in Romania. Again, going back to our point about the tremendous workforce that Romania has, but also, I think there's a great opportunity in the healthcare sector as well, and that's a growing area where if there was a lot of openness to working with some of the pharmaceutical companies, I think you'd see more research and development coming to Romania. You'd see more clinical testing, more clinical trials, and the creation of more jobs. But most importantly, innovative medicines that will ensure the people of Romania are receiving the best medicine possible.
I would like to discuss now about one of the main topics globally, but which is not discussed at all in Romania, which is the TTIP, the Transatlantic Partnership. What did you hear from the Romanian authorities about this subject? Because I know you talk about it.
Yes.
Which is the position of the Romanian authorities?
They're clearly in favor of it, which is great, because a stronger Europe relationship with America is going to naturally benefit Romania. The message that I will tell you we delivered from the business community on this transatlantic free trade agreement is to please conclude it and conclude it quickly, because we have elections coming up on both sides of the equation, and when elections happen, things stop. And this is a moment in time that is very unique. We had our president, you know, discuss this issue in his State of the Union. The time is now. And if we miss this window of opportunity, we may not have it again for a very long time. So I think it's important to not focus on whether this sector is in or whether this sector is out. The negotiators, our encouragement would be to find what we can agree on, find the common ground, the low-hanging fruit, and negotiate it and get it done. Because that agreement, even minimal, will be more significant than the last three free trade agreements that America has signed with other countries. It's big. Even if it's minimal, it's big. So it's important, and Romania will benefit from that.
Do you feel that Romania is reluctant to having this free trade agreement in some fields, let's say agriculture or energy? Do you think that we are reluctant to this?
My feeling is that overall Romania supports the idea of a free trade agreement. Every country has things they don't want to give up, or they don't want to move in. Agriculture is certainly one of the most difficult. All 50 of our states have agriculture issues that are of interest to them that they don't want negotiated in a free trade agreement. And I would say the same, obviously, for the European Union countries. They all have issues. But again, I think if we can focus on the big picture and focus on what can be done, that's what will be essential.
You are saying that Romania will certainly benefit from this trade agreement if concluded. Do you have any numbers? How much can the Romanian economy grow from this agreement if concluded?
I don't. I'm sorry. I don't have those numbers. But it will benefit. There's no question. I mean, again, a healthy Europe and a healthy America, we need that. The globe needs to have. The whole world needs a healthy America and a healthy Europe, and there's no question how closely intertwined our economies are to one another. And if America, as we've seen, when America is not well, then Europe is not well. But if we're able to conclude this, we're talking, you know, trillions of dollars of business that will clearly benefit both sides, and Romania being a part of that.
I'm asking you this because there is no internal debate here in Romania about this huge topic, and we are asking everybody why is not a topic, why is nobody talking about it. It's a kind of a non-subject here, so we are trying to understand what stops the Romanian authorities talking about it, because it's so huge.
It is huge, and it's a positive thing. Obviously if it's passed, it's positive, but you know, that's not unique to Romania. As I spend time with other leaders in Central Europe, it's the same. It's not talked about a lot here. Frankly, outside of Washington, it's not talked about a lot in America. It's sort of an inside, as we say, inside baseball. It's kind of a discussion among politicians and business leaders. It's not a discussion among everyday citizens. And so that's why I think you don't hear a lot about it. But it is important, and we'll all certainly see the benefits.
I see. Which are the next steps that you and your council are going to make towards Romania in relation to Romania?
We'll be celebrating Romanian National Day in December in Washington. That'll be our next event, and we're also very happy that we'll finally have our new Romanian ambassador to Washington, Ilian Buga, will be arriving at that time and presenting his credentials. So we're very excited about that. So that'll be a new chapter in our relationship. But what I hope to substantively work on over the next few months is, again, we put together some type of a roadmap and a strategy and a plan between our two countries, and again, not just us, but with a greater greater influence of other partners in this process. And my hope is that we can create this roadmap again, which will help us to not only create a transparent, stable environment, but will also address some specific industry issues and identify where those next opportunities are for more business between America and Romania. And hopefully we get to a point where we're having discussions about Romanian companies needing access to do business in America. That's really where we begin to have a full, healthy relationship, and when it's going both ways. And so we would like to be very supportive and helpful to the Romanians.
Are there any Romanian companies besides the IT companies which are globalized? Are there any Romanian companies right now willing to go to the American market? Did you talk to any of them, or did you find one?
I small ones. I've come across small companies here and there, not large companies. But my organization only represents American companies. But that's something that we want, and we want to support. And so if we are asked to help with Romanian companies trying to access the American market, that's something that we will certainly help with.
But as you know, right now the Romanian economy, do you think there are any Romanian companies strong enough to go to the American market?
I don't know. I wouldn't be a good person to ask.
My last question is, if you were the Prime Minister or the President of Romania for one day, what would you change, or what in the economy field, what would you change, or what would you put in the first line on this roadmap of mutual cooperation?
Well, I will point out that that I'm actually 3 months older than your prime minister. We are the same age. We were born in the same year. I would like to see, if I had the ability, and I could, as we say in the U.S., if you could wave a magic wand, mm-hmm. and what could you fix? It would be to fix the bureaucracy, fix the process generally, and how companies interface with business. Things like the ability to open a business. You should be able to open a business in hours, not days, and sometimes weeks and months, depending on the country. Those types of things are essential for attracting investment, attracting business. It should be a really easy process. It shouldn't be difficult. So that would be to wave the magic wand to make it very efficient, so that the government is a supportive player versus the process is being an impediment.
Do you think, generally speaking, that in this part of Europe, government is too important for the economy, is more important than it should be?
It's an evolution. I mean, when you consider where the countries in Central Europe were just 20 years ago, where everything was about the government, you've seen the barometer slowly move in the right direction. And as we create these democracies, and you have a democracy, but as you create the more businesses and more business environment, and get rid of these the oligarchs, and get rid of the large government-run companies. We still have them in the U.S. I mean, there are still industries that are run essentially by our government, the Postal Service, and those types of things. But as we see the privatizations take place, it becomes less and less. But this, I believe, Central Europe is probably one of the most exciting places to be doing business. You look at Romania's 2.6 GDP growth. In a normal scenario, that wouldn't be anything to be excited about. But when you measure that against the other countries in Europe and what's happening globally, it is something to be excited about. And I think there's just a tremendous amount of opportunities because Romania is really, in a sense, 20 years young. Since reemerging, there are lots of opportunities for bringing new technologies and bringing new standards and bringing new businesses, and it's only going to grow, and Romania is only going to continue to grow stronger.
But it was a lot of talk here in Romania about the fact that the United States are slowly moving their focus from Europe to towards Asia, Southeastern Asia, and so where the markets are much bigger than this part of Europe, where the stability is bigger than here in Southeastern Europe. How can you explain the fact that the American companies are still interested in this part of Europe?
Again, businesses don't listen to the government. Mm-hmm. Businesses do what businesses are going to do, and they base that on investment climate type decisions. I think this is a very natural evolution. This is sort of the new normal. As Romania and Poland and the Czech Republic are all emerging as strong, healthy economies and strong, healthy countries, and their roles increase and become more influential in Brussels and within Europe, it's a natural progression that there would be less sort of U.S. Aid programs and less U.S. Handouts and those types of things because Romania is becoming a big, strong, independent country that doesn't need those types of programs anymore. What I hope remains is our special relationship and that we continue to have that special relationship on many fronts. But more Europe and more Brussels is very natural progression, I think, for all the countries as you've all now joined the European Union. And now I think what's interesting to see is how America and Romania will work on third country projects. How we work on things in like Moldova, like Ukraine, Central Asia, the Caucasus, and to even together in Europe and Asia, as you see the Great Silk Road being re-strengthened. I think there are opportunities for us to work together in other areas.
Which are the countries in this area that Romania is in a good position to work with Americans to go there? Besides Moldova, which is natural, which are the other countries? Georgia or Azerbaijan?
I've actually seen a number of scenarios to indicate to me that Romania has the real potential to be a hub, and not just a hub east, but a hub back west. We're seeing some trends where American companies and global companies may be moving global headquarters from Western Europe to Central Europe, because a lot of the things we talked about. And that gives them a strategic location to be able to do business within the EU, but then also east, where there's lots of new opportunities and new markets.
Around the Black Sea.
Around the Black Sea, yeah, absolutely. And even into Central Asia. I mean, we've seen some visits at the highest level going back and forth between Romania and Central Asia and even further. So I think there's a real unique opportunity. And energy is a natural for those discussions for many reasons, but I think it can go much more than that.
Thank you. These were my questions. If you have anything to add to this, please.
Oh, I would just indicate we've got just by way of background, 10 companies that are on this mission. AMRO has 15 companies. We started with 8, so we've almost doubled in the 2 years that we've existed. And the only other thing I would mention is, again, I spent a lot of time promoting. I also spend time talking to our Congress. And I think one of the important issues that I always want to make sure that Romanians understand is the issue of visa waiver, which is a very important issue. And to make sure that it's understood that this issue is not about Romania. The reason that Romania is not in the visa waiver has nothing to do with Romania and has everything to do with our immigration policies and restrictions from in the Western Hemisphere. It's very unfortunate because Romania is one of our greatest friends anywhere in the world, and they deserve to be in the program. But unfortunately, our politics, like everyone's politics, are very challenging. And one of the things that we are doing as AMRO and myself personally as the president, spending time educating our members of Congress. We have 75 new Republicans that came into our Congress, educating them on the importance of leaving out our closest allies in this important program. And this is not for political or diplomatic reasons, it's for business reasons. This is an impediment to us doing business together. So that would be the only other issue that I would mention. It's very important. And I hope the Romanian people understand that this is not in some way America saying we don't like Romania or we don't value Romania or we don't appreciate Romania. It's the furthest from the truth. It's about our immigration issues.
Eric Stewart, thank you very much.
Thank you.